Alright, here we are, Bubble Gloop Swamp. Remember how I said bottles is right behind the exit in the last level? I was wrong. It's in this level. Ah. And now he's gonna give me the boots, so I can walk in... I don't know if I can walk in lava, but I can walk in, like, hot sand and the, swampy areas that supposedly apparently have piranhas in them, because piranhas live in swamps? I don't know. But anyways. Always like the music for this game. Or for this game. Well, for this game in general, but for this level. I think I gotta feed 5 of these crocodiles, if I remember right, to get that cheeky. Truthfully, I don't remember a flying segment in this level that I would need those red feathers for, but I'm sure there is one if they're giving them to me. See, I can go for the water. And if these boots run out, then I'm gonna get hurt. There's one Jinjo. It's yellow. He was the one that took me the longest last time. Yeah, see? Piranhas. Piranhas. In the swamp. Alright, so this part's fun. It's a race to get this jiggy that'll disappear if I don't get up there fast enough. But in order to do it, you have to use the talent trot the whole time on these really narrow ledges. So. And not panic when you make a false step. That way you can get here in enough time to actually be careful and not fall off. Alright, now I'll go back and get those notes. See, this is what happens when you move too fast. I almost fell off right there. Alright, green Jinjo. Aha! I win. Ooh, 7. We just jumped up a lot. Ah. That one's way high up there. Oh, get on the log. There's, this is the frogs? Yeah, this is the frogs. So they say I'm just gonna kill all the stupid little frogs. So basically I'm just short hopping and pressing B because it's a faster attack. So it does strike me as funny that, in a lot of these situations, Banjo might actually be the villain, because he's taking the jiggies, the gold, whatever they call it, from all these different creatures, by force, by killing them. I mean, I know he's trying to rescue his sister and all of that. Not sure he's going about it. Of course, I also pretty firmly believe that, for any of you familiar with the Kirby games, that Kirby is actually the villain. I have a really good theory on that. Hey! Yay for witch switches. Alright, so this one's gonna work against tough. Let's see. Won't go that far? It will go that far again. There we go. Took way longer than it should have. Hooray! Down there, so I gotta go down back here and grab the boots that are somewhere. Hooray. Now I can walk in piranha water. Hello, hooray! Oh, you know what? I'm supposed to come back here as the crocodile. Forget this part. I'll be back here. I mean, it's nice to be able to just walk back and not have to jump on these things. Still not what I wanted. Notice by being mean to the turtle, they've made it so that I'm actually helping him by getting his feet warm. Ugh. And the Bookiopedia. Yeah, this is, any level is better than Clankers. Yeah, a lot of people don't like Bubblegum Swamp. I actually kind of do. I mean, it's just a nice quick one. It's pretty straightforward, but it's not annoying, I guess. There's several levels that are just, they have more annoying elements. I don't find this one annoying the same. So that's why I don't mind this one quite as much. Ugh. Yeah, Rusty Bucket Bay is really annoying. You are not wrong. Ugh, I wasn't watching the turtles. Okay, I think I know which one's the worst. Nope. Alright, I'll let you watch this time. Sorry about that. Yes, Rusty Bucket Bay does have good music. I think my favorite music is Mad Monster Mansion, which I probably won't get to tonight, but alright, so purple, red, yellow. Easy peasy. Nope. Listen to blue, red, purple, wait, blue, 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 red, purple, light blue, and blue. Oh, is it not that way in the HD remake? Oh, hold on. Purple. Oh, wait. Lavender. Okay. Okay, I think I know how that went. This is the worst one to actually try to talk on, you know? Yeah. It was definitely this guy next. I think it was you. It's either you or the dark blue one. Nope, it's the dark blue one. Alright, I'm gonna try it again. Alright, so. Start over here. Or nope, start it over here. Oh, it's gonna make me listen to it again. Oh crap, every time I get it wrong, I lose health. That's awesome. That's super awesome. Alright, I need to go find health, and then I guess I'll come back in here. Ugh, I didn't want you to repeat it. I was just looking for more health. Yeah, I didn't... I played the HD version and liked it. And, I mean, that was a couple years ago, though. And, I thought I remembered being able to keep all the notes when you left a level. But yeah, no, that burned me a couple times. Well, I guess just once on the stream, once when I was playing, offline. Alright, so here we go. I'm gonna do this right, or I'm gonna die and lose all those notes, just like we talked about. There we go. That's better. Yeah. When I went through Treasure Trove Cove, I went in the Shark Food Island and kind of explained stop and swap. Because I've got a 100% file on this game, and when you activate stop and swap stuff on one file, it just goes ahead and activates them on all of them. But yeah, stop and swap's an interesting thing. Zigzag is down. And then goes backwards. No. Then comes back to you. Then I think it went to you. Yes. Hey, Deadbeat Kids. I missed you last Tuesday. Yeah, I wish they had done something with Stop and Swap. It would have been cool. I understand why they scrapped it. It was a good way to ruin games. But, no, Debbie, I actually didn't have to start over. I took the game out and put it back in. Well, first I took it apart, thinking, oh, I've got to replace the battery, and then I realized there's no battery in Banjo-Kazooie. Your saves can just kind of disappear if the game's not seated in there properly. So I lost what we did last week, but I had an old save file on there that was, that I'd gotten up to Clanker's Cavern on, so I actually just got on a little early tonight and cleared it, so now we're moving forward. So that's actually kind of nice. Really what? About the battery thing? Yeah, last week I went to play it because I had cleared Mumbo's Mountain and Treasure Trove Cove the week before. And, can I actually pay attention? There are 12, N64 games that have batteries. And I don't remember what they are. They're early ones, like Super Mario 64. Because it was kind of a holdover from the SNES until they, figured out what to do. But then they were able to house all of the batteries, well, not really batteries. I think they put flash memory in there to keep it. But, yeah. Basically, there's only 12 of them that don't... Oh, there we go. There's only 12 of them that do the battery backup thing. Oh, yeah. Oh. Oh, that's right. Hit it in different places. Yeah. Oh, time to beat Garch. Hey, there we go. Hey, we got a couple more viewers. Welcome. And I'm just going to go get the boots. I don't feel like coming back with the crocodile. to get those notes that are over there. Hi there, Arovan, right? Yeah, I don't know. I would actually be curious to know that too, Bookiopedia. That's actually something that, because part of this channel is about the history and the random facts that nobody else would care about. So that's something that I should look up for next time. I think I'm gonna get piranha'd. Come on, just give me that note. That's all I want. There we go. Oh! Oh, he gave me a freebie and I didn't get hit there. Come on. I haven't played the... I haven't really gotten into The Walking Dead because I know that I'll just lose way, way, way too much time. I don't even know why I got these because I was reading chat, that's why. But I'll just use them. Well, good. I'm pretty sure that Twitch was specifically designed so that people could live vicariously through other people playing games, so I think you're in good shape. But yeah, I actually hear that the Walking Dead Telltale game is actually really good. But then again, most Telltale games are good as long as you like that style of game. The one they did on Fables was fantastic. Hey! Some of those stupid crocodiles. I haven't seen these guys in a while. I think I got hit by them. Ah. Take that back. So Mumbo's hut is around here somewhere. Not sure where that is. Ooh, we got a few more viewers. Welcome, everyone. Yeah, I think Wolf Among Us is actually... Oh, it's right, he's in the fort. I think Wolf Among Us is my favorite Telltale game. I also, more just because I'm a Homestar Runner fan, enjoyed Strombad's Cool Game for Attractive People. That was a lot of fun. Oh yeah, I mean, they're basically visual novels for, you know, more or less. Yeah, I feel like Humble Bundle and Telltale are, like... Oh, SJ, you gotta do Fables. It's a little rough, but knowing you, I'm pretty sure that it's nothing that you would be offended by or anything like that. Great story though. But yeah, I'm pretty sure that Humble and Telltale must have like a recurring deal or something. I think that's like the fourth Telltale bundle I've seen. Always different games, but. Boots have a timer, and they're designed so that they will run out exactly when you need them again. Or exactly when. Basically, at just the right time, and if you delay at all, then, like, if I miss a note and go back for it or something like that, then I won't get to the next set of boots before I get hurt. Yeah. Alright, so now... Oh, this part, okay. Alright, Bookiopedia, I see you type something there. I'm gonna not read it until I'm done with this part, because otherwise I'm not gonna do it. I was complaining the other day about how the N64's control stick is not nearly as precise as the Xbox's was. Okay. Yeah, Bookiopedia, I kind of feel the same way. I don't usually watch games that are that are narrative heavy. I feel like I'd rather just play through it myself. Unless I just know that I'm not gonna end up playing it. Here we go. Hey, here we go, Mumbo Skull. Can't attack while I'm wearing these stupid things. Well, that was cheap. Glad that wasn't my last hit. I would have been mad. I know it's bad, right? Come on. There we go. Deadbeat, did you guys end up playing Mario Maker last Tuesday? I totally meant to tune in and ended up getting sucked up in the set that I was working on. Nice thing about the crocodile, don't have to worry about the piranhas anymore. Nice thing about the Mumbo transformations too, you don't take fall damage. You fall from a mile up and not get hurt. Most annoying part of this level, all the notes and random in the extremities of the level that you can't get without the crocodile. Oh, is there? Yeah. I felt like there was another way out, but I didn't feel like looking for it. I'll use that next time. Oh. Huh. Yeah, but World 7 though, Mario. Oh, sweet. For this Thursday? Actually, I might be able to watch that. What time are you streaming? Yeah. So this is basically whack-a-mole, except if you lose, he ends up coming up and biting you. Oh, you know what? I need... Oh, I can't actually beat this without the boots. There's a move that I'm missing. So the trick to this is you just keep on tapping B, because when you're snapping like that, you actually move faster. And then you try to stay ahead of him and eat the ones that he's going after. That way, you're not only getting more, you're stealing the ones that he was going to eat. Kind of try to isolate him. Ha. Said about this analog stick not being super precise? Yeah, I lost my lead. There we go. Ah! Yeah. If you tie with them, I'm pretty sure you still lose, if I remember right. Ah! Oh, it's so close! You didn't win! You tied! You don't get to eat me for tying! Fine. I'll take the hit. I'll bite you back. Didn't work. Alright. Well, Deadbeat, I'm pretty sure the reason for watching Twitch streams isn't, I'm pretty sure that I can vicariously live through you losing, too, because I sure as heck did a ton of that when I was a kid, so. Nope, mine. I feel like one of the little birds in Finding Nemo. Mine. Find him and get out of here. See, he's smart. He tries to go the other way if he knows that I'm in front of him. Yeah. No. Alright, I think if I let him bite me, he's gonna kill me, so I'm gonna run away. Woo! Just missed. Okay. So this is where I get to go find more health, because I don't want to die. Otherwise, I'll lose all my newts. How many newts do I have? 91? Oh gosh, that would suck so much. The jumping, biting attack thing was not working out for me. Okay, and going back down. Alright, I know I can beat Mr. Vile without the shoes. It's just more annoying this way. Are the shoes in this level? No, the shoes aren't in this level. The shoes are in the desert level, I think. Alright, if I can just stay ahead of him, I'll be fine. Yeah. Ugh, we gotta do the easy one first, because I ran away. For the easy mode one, you can basically just go to the biggest bunch of these things and just keep going. And you can win fairly easily. And he doesn't run as fast either. Ugh! Remember how I was just saying it was easy mode? Well, apparently I was wrong. Yeah, that didn't work out. Ah! You freaking kidding me? But if I can steal a couple of his, then... Nope, not gonna work. Alright, bite me so we can do this again. Yeah, but I haven't learned the running shoes move yet. That's the problem. Pretty sure that the running shoes are that you learn the move in the desert level. Slipping off of the analog stick. put some gaff tape on this thing or something, increase the grip. Nope, mine. Okay. Easy mode over. Somehow I still got there before him. No idea how that happened. Oh, I went the wrong way. Crap. Last game. Ugh. There's three of them? Awful. Awful, awful, awful. Dumb game. Bleh. What? Oh. Changed on me. Not actually getting these. I'm so losing. Oh, I totally ate it when it was the right one. It's cheating. One more time, let's see. Alright. Alright, so if it changes, then I'm... Come on. I was in the middle of a bunch of yellow ones. Seriously? I think I'm gonna be close enough where he's gonna actually bite me and kill me. No, 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 no. Awful. I knew I shouldn't have challenged him again. Alright, I think that one's just gonna have to wait. Or maybe I'll go get the other ones with the gingers while my fingers recharge. I know. That face, that Binding of Isaac face, is exactly how I feel right now. I'll try it again once I finish the rest of the level, but I'm gonna get the rest of this done first. Do I keep the Jinjos? Nope. That would be too easy. Ah, I lost a couple of viewers over that. Oh well. These guys. Ah. Camera's killing me. Things evil. I was gonna try to 100% this level by 9, and considering that I got a little bit of a late start on it, I still might not show up at my original time. I'm just staying in crocodile form because it's easier to get a lot of these notes this way. That's how I get up there. Don't need to do that yet. I thought there were notes back here. Mean trick. Those notes are actually above water. Watch, I bet I can walk under it. Yep, just to make it annoying. There's no other reason you would do that. It's not like they can't put them in the water. They put them in the water in the other parts. Mean. Oh yeah, I know it's because I'm supposed to go through with boots, but it wouldn't have taken any more effort for them just to put the notes in the water in case I was the crocodile. There's no notes over there right now. Oh, there's a Mumbo token back there. I'm gonna grab that. They knew. I'm sure they did know. I think they knew that they were doing it just to be annoying. Alright. Guys at Rares are no dummies. Ah. I always hate that. If you press B too quickly when you push down the skull, it doesn't actually transform you. You just end up punching or, in my case, chomping your way off. Alright, it's just red feathers up there. I don't care. There's one, one level where there's actually notes up there. So, yeah, so there's the slit where I'd go out if I was. Just trying to kill this one. Get hurt here. Let's go. How many jiggies do I have left to get? Two more. So one's from Mr. Vile, one's from the Jinjos, so there's one other one somewhere. Oh, the stupid golden crocodiles. I'm gonna have to go shoot them all again. Alright, forget what I said about this being a straightforward and easy level. It sucks if you die, then it's not straightforward anymore. That sounds like an awesome sweatshirt. People popping in and out, so if I haven't said it yet while you've been here, welcome. Right, there's a bunch of notes up here, and there's a Jinjo up here, too. Oop. You know, I thought about one of these days playing Donkey Kong 64. Because there's a lot of great moments in it, but there's also a lot of just really needlessly frustrating moments. Oh, is it yellow that I'm missing? Yep, I know. Yes, okay. I just gotta find the entrance, which is over here. Jinjo Jiggy down. You know, I need to replay Donkey Kong 64. Yeah, Bookiopedia. I feel exactly the same way. Because, like, it's critically panned and, like, nobody seems to like it, but I don't remember it being as that bad. Remember it was inferior to Banjo-Kazooie, for sure, but I don't remember it being that bad, but it gets a pretty bad rap, so I'm pretty sure that I might have some rose-colored glasses in that department. Alright, now there were some notes inside of this. Always love this part. The TK rap is killer. It might kill you. No, I remember, that when it came out, actually, it was a lot of fun. The DK rap. His coconut gun can fire in spurts. If he shoots you, it's gonna hurt. Somebody should do a dramatic reading of the Donkey Kong rap and post it on YouTube. I'd totally watch that. Ah, I was trying to get smart. Didn't work. Right? Right? I feel like it would go so well, a dramatic reading of that. Well, hey, I just passed my best note score. Okay, so I've got 6. He's the leader of the bunch. You know him well. There's my Kentucky accent coming out. You know him well. He's finally back to kick some tail. Give me another one. Test me. I'm curious to see how good I am. I don't know if I remember this whole thing or not, but it's coming back. Oh, I know the last Jiggy that I need. I need to get the stupid one for the stupid crocodiles. Alright. Well, I know there's no more notes up here, so I'm heading down. Alright, so there's 6 notes left to get. Usually when you've got 6 notes left to get, that usually means that you're missing one group, one or two groups, because they're usually in groups of 3s or 6s. Or 4s, but there's no even... You know, 4 is not a multiple of 6, so I don't think it's that. I don't remember where that, I don't remember what the next part of that was. Darn, only the third time and you stumped me already. New mistake. Pretty sure that chat was, one of the purposes it was invented for was to make streamers die when they're looking and reading. Walnuts, peanuts, coconut shells. Coconut shells was the next part. Nope, not coming. Not coming. I tried. I know. It's coconut shells, and I know that's the next part. I just can't remember what closes it. The only problem with streaming Donkey Kong 64 is it's like twice as long as Banjo-Kazooie, or at least takes twice as long to clear, so I'd be playing it for forever. Oh, this is gonna work out. Pineapple smells, yes. Because, yeah, Chunky's got the pineapple cannon, that's right. Where was I going? Oh yeah, I think the next one was up here. Hey! Oh, missed the Mumbo token, but I don't particularly care. Man, why did I do Mr. Vile when I was this close to getting this last Jiggy? Oh my gosh, a deadbeat. I really wanted to play an NES remix, but I don't know. I didn't buy it at the time, and I noticed that they've actually made a collection now, right? With Remix 1 and 2. See the mosquito? He was like frozen in midair there. It's kind of interesting. Yeah, that's one of those ones that it's kind of gray area. I think I can probably play it on the stream according to the rules since it's all classic games. So I was thinking of it's kind of falls in the same category as Mario Maker. So I was thinking of playing it on the stream for the first time. I figured that might be fun to watch. Okay, good. I thought that I was back here. Kill the mosquito before. Yeah, I like watching people stream the first time they play a game because you get all the authentic reactions and everything to everything that's happening. So I think that's a lot of fun when people do that. Alright, so I think the only notes that I have left are the ones in Mr. Vile's house. So I think I can go back, do the crocodile thing, and be done with Bubble Loop Swamp. Except I'm going the wrong way. A blue egg thing in the water? Yeah, they're just eggs for that move right there. I don't need any more right now. They were nice though. They put the crocodile, the thing that you have to have the crocodile for, right next to the place where you turn into the crocodile. So that's nice of them. Deadbeat, are you playing tomorrow night? So, Bookiopedia, what kind of stuff do you usually stream? Ugh. I hear that, Deadbeat. A couple weeks ago, I couldn't even... I started the stream, 15 minutes late because I had to reset my router. What time are you streaming tomorrow? Because I've got to do some editing, and I figured I might turn it on while I'm doing that. Alright. Here we go. Back to Mr. Vile. Ooh, Stardew Valley. A little Harvest Moon action. Did you play Harvest Moon back in the day? I've heard really good things about Stardew Valley. Really, really good things. Ah, I'm missing three notes somewhere. Oh, wait. There they are. Ha! I win! Alright, cool. So now I can actually do this and not have anything to lose. Yeah, Stardew looks really fun, actually. I used to love Harvest Moon. Alright. Come back. Oh, closing on my lead. Come on, come on, come on. Ah! Control stick's killing me, man. Ugh. I will tell you all about my streaming hardware as soon as I'm done with this, because he doesn't wait for me to check chat before he goes. Yeah, the more you steal from him, the faster he goes, so you gotta be careful about that. If you steal from him too much, then he becomes kind of, like, unbeatable. Become Super Crocodile. Oh, I missed! Oh, you lose your lead so fast. Ah! I was right there! My dog heard me yell, so now she's checking on me. It's okay. Okay, let's see. I can catch up on chat. Yeah, streaming, you'd think that it was... you'd think that it's easier. I'm, like, brain dead after... I get done streaming. It's why I gave myself the 2-hour time limit, because I'm an introvert. I can't do it for longer than 2 hours without having issues. Going after yours. Going after you. Oh, you gotta be kidding me. What a tease. Ah. Ugh! Popped up right in front of me. Come on, I need a good group here to pop up in front of me so I can catch up. Yes. At this point, I just gotta maintain my lead. Ha! Eat it. That's interesting, having, that's an interesting idea, Debbie, and I don't think I've ever seen anybody else do that. Oh, crap. Need reds. Ugh. Alright, it's gonna change to yellow. Oh, he is so far ahead. I need to start stealing his. That's not fair! It switched! Alright, well, I'm not beating this now. I got smoked. Alright, this is the last time I'm doing this part, and then I'm moving on to Freeze Easy Pete. I'll come back to this once I've got the shoes, although it bothers me, because I used to beat this the first time through. That was always part of the fun, but I feel like I'm gonna get boring if I do that. This is gonna take me a few more tries. Oh, why are all the yellows on his side? Ah! No! I totally thought he got another one! Sweet! Ah! Okay. Oh, Deadbeat, I'm sorry. You'll have to not watch this struggle. Oh no, I'm scared. I am... Wow, that's high stakes. I am not doing that. Do you want the actual name, Jake? If you want the actual name, they're Grumblies. If you want the definition of what they are, they're the things that I have to eat to win the game. There's really no logical explanation to it. Apparently, alligators like to eat Grumblies in Banjo-Kazooie world. Man, my heart's still like racing from that. Jeez. I totally didn't think I was going to win that. Alright, go out. This part's easier if I just stay as a